Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Sunbury Motors, North 4th Street in Sunbury, and Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Good afternoon, everybody. It is the Steve Jones Show on a hump day. Matt Catrillo here with you. Steve will soon be there from the Sunbury Motors Studio. Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And online at sunburymotors.com. Ford, Kia, Hyundai, and a great selection of pre-owned inventory if that's where your budget says you need to head down towards. But you have a sales staff that... Either way, whether you're looking for that brand new car or whether you're looking for that used car, they're there for you and not just there for the sale. And either way, once you get that new or used car, you have a service department that's there for you when whatever you need it. They get it done with the diagnostics, with the inspections, with all of the routine maintenance. They have it all. It's all part of that Sunbury Motors guarantee, trying to save you money every day. And that's all at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf, online at sunburymotors.com. Got John Sauber today from the Center Daily Times. Lots to get into with Penn State. We'll talk a little football, men's basketball. Steve got into a little bit of the why of the reseat for men's basketball inside the BJC. If you missed that yesterday, that's on our Facebook page and also at stevejonesshow.com. And it all made sense. I understand those who have been season ticket holders for a long time in that same spot. I understand you the probable beef you have with that, but I would probably have to agree with Steve that if it hasn't been done for that long, 20-plus years, I think he said yesterday, then I guess it was a long time overdue. But that's there at stevejonesshow.com and on our Facebook page, so we'll get into that. Football offseason and more with John coming up in a little bit. And then tomorrow, the King is going to join us. The King's going to join us tomorrow and next Thursday as well, as I am off these next two Fridays. So we'll look forward to having the King back tomorrow from the beach, I believe, which will be fun. So looking forward to that. NBA free agency... The rumors keep a-flying. Nothing really involving the Sixers too much yet. The only big news of the day is the Wizards finalizing the deal to acquire Will Barton and Monte Morris from the Nuggets for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope and Ish Smith, according to Woj. And the NBA salary cap likely to hit $123.6 million for next year. And then... Last night, you had the big trade for the Knicks. They were trading Nerlens Noel and Alec Burks to the Pistons, which clears $19 million in cap space. And that makes them now eligible to make a big contract offer to free agent Grizzly guard Jalen Brunson in the neighborhood of $110 million. Knicks included two future second-round picks and $6 million to incentivize the trade, according to ESPN. So that gives them $30 million in cap space to make a massive four-year deal for Brunson. So it'll be 4 years in the neighborhood of $110 million. As much as I would not want to see that happen since I'm a Sixers fan, I don't. The Knicks need a heck of a lot more than Jalen Brunson. after his breakout year with the Mavericks. Still be a good get for the Knicks, a big one, but I think they would still have a long way to go. And as far as the Sixers go, it looks like they might be bringing in P.J. Tucker for that three-year, $30 million deal when free agency officially opens at 6 p.m. tomorrow. And I'm all for that. I know P.J. Tucker's 37. I know that's a lot of money for a 37-year-old, but that's just the nature of it. The Sixers are in win-now mode. P.J. Tucker is the perfect complement to Joel Embiid. And you help build that depth that you so desperately need down low with Embiid and around Embiid. I thought he played great in the playoffs. He was like that relentless, physical guy that got a lot of key rebounds. Actually made some key shots, too, for the Heat. So I think that'd be a good move for the Sixers.
What, moving the franchise? Are they moving?
No. That's not... Well...
Because you're not going to get any free agents now with the hate that exists in that city.
I'm saying they might... That looks like they're going to get P.J. Tucker once free agency starts.
That's nice. That doesn't move the needle. He's a good pro.
But it's another good depth signing that the Sixers need right now, especially to complement Joel Embiid. I'm all for it. I know it's a lot of money for a 37-year-old, but I don't care. You're in win-now mode. Go do it.
Something tells me I feel a twinge in the middle of the season coming on. All right. Age is... Oh, well. Hammer and I just had a talk about age. So it's like, okay.
There you go.
Oh, you wake up and a lot of things are sore. It's like, oh boy. All right. So you're going to sign a 90-year-old to back up Joel Embiid. Okay, good. That's great. He's a functional player. He doesn't swing the balance of power. I know you hate when I do these things, but it's just a fact. I mean, he's a good pro. But, I mean, you kind of feel like they've won the championship by getting him. And it's like, no. Okay. Like the Pirates signing a guy like that. Okay, great.
Well, the Pirates would have virtually no talent around them. The Sixers do.
And when's the last time you got out of the second round?
Well, they're making those moves to get past that, which is these depth moves. But you're right. They need to get over that hump.
They have a great player. Maxey's turned out to be really good. They got problems almost everywhere else. Harris has his moments. He's up and down. Maxey's been terrific for them. I thought the draft trade was excellent. Melton helps them. And James Harden is... Hey, he's your guy. All right, good. Let's see here. Judge homered again today, right?
Yes, and Stanton.
Fourth inning?
Yes. the fifth inning, maybe.
Yeah, well, it wasn't a walk-off. He's never hit one of those. So he just does. He has no feel for the moment.
Third inning.
So you doubt me on this stuff. You doubt me. Am I wrong? No.
Yeah, 5-3 in the seventh. Top of the seventh.
Against Sacramento? Good. Nice.
The Sacramento of baseball? Yeah.
And I guess in the Pirates game, they stopped the game for 10 minutes trying to review, going over a play. They claimed in the end that Washington left the field too quickly after a double play, and because of that, they couldn't appeal. And they let a run score, and it turned out it was the wrong call. And they stopped the game for 10 minutes to do that. What are we doing here?
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
What are we doing? This is the second time that's happened. But you stop the game, you go around in a circle, and you still got it wrong. Nationals lead 6-5 in the top of the sixth. Brewers lead the Rays 4-3 top of the eighth. Astros, Mets scoreless in the top of the eighth. Yankees lead the A's 5-3. Stanton hit a home run, but it was before the fourth inning. Rangers and Royals 1-1 in the top of the fifth. What a brutal game that is. Let's give the Orioles credit. They're 35-41. You know what? Let's give credit where credit's due. They are playing a lot better. Now, that record may change for them because now you're going to start playing more divisional games. But they have made up some ground playing out of the division, to their credit. In terms of making up ground, getting to 500. They're six games under. Let's give credit where credit's due. Phillies are 39-36. Schwarber had another long home run last night. Schwarber's got 22 home runs, but Harper's out, 6 weeks? Broken thumb? That stinks. Ugh, that stinks. They got Ranger Suarez on the mound tonight against Kyle Wright. As they take on the Braves tonight, let's see. Cunha foot expected to be out until June 30th. That's tomorrow. Albie's out till September 1st. Jackson's out till July 6th. Aaron Judge is out till September 3rd. Did I get that wrong?
FOULED. That spells fouled up.
Telling you, he's gonna get a twinge. You don't believe me.
You're just a cruel person.
No, every year he gets one. Hey, come on, what's being cruel talking about a guy's career? That's his career, right?
To a point, sure.
Yes, to a point. Yes, you'll get a twinge. Oh, well. Yeah, we'll see who everybody can acquire in the before the 31st. The rich will get richer. The poor will get poorer. And you'll have all the franchises in the poor market saying, we got prospects. You got nothing. Okay. They sat back in the rich markets and went, which four guys can we give them? Because we really don't want them. Right? Rob Manfred claims he really does. He was asked. The first question he gets asked by Don Van Adam. First question. Do you hate baseball? That was the first question he got.
Kudos to that reporter. That's awesome.
Now, I want to be fair to Manfred. Okay, so let's try that for a moment. Let's be fair to him. He is a lawyer. He is also the only commissioner in the history of the game that has played Little League. The only one that ever played Little League baseball. It's only him. All right. Could field, couldn't hit. He freely admits that. Ends up going to Harvard Law School. So what has he done right? What do you think he's done right? I know what you're going to say. Nothing.
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
Because, I mean, I know how your mind now works. So let's start with this. What has he done right? You now have the universal DH in both leagues. That's right. You now have that game in Williamsport every year in association with the Little League World Series. That's right. They put the Field of Dreams game in last year in Iowa, the White Sox and Yankees. That was right. These are all good, positive things for baseball. They did that game down at Fort Bragg, okay, between the Marlins and the Braves for the military. Right, that's right. They, in a sport that desperately needs a floor and a cap, this is the fine line where Rob Manfred does have to walk. It's not that he has to walk a fine line between the players and the owners, which is obvious, because the players don't want it. But the problem is he's got owners on his side that don't want it either. Owners in Baltimore, Kansas City, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Colorado, Arizona. I'm trying to think who, Tampa, Miami. They don't want it. I've just named eight owners that don't want it. You need 27 to pass something. He can't even get the idea of a cap floor past his own ownership, because the Pirates want to spend $35 million. And the disparity between the $247 million that the Dodgers are spending and the Pirates spending $35, you're talking about a $212 million disparity in payroll. And is it any coincidence that the team that is spending $247 is averaging $48,000 a game, and the team that's spending $35 is averaging $12? I mean, these guys don't get it. And you've got to rein it in a little bit. $200, $100, or look, okay, let's appease the players and make it $250 and $100. But they got the luxury tax. I mean, so he's got to walk a fine line on some of this stuff. And he's got empirical evidence in the NHL, the NBA, and the NFL that floor cap works for competitive balance. But he can't even convince his own people of that. And nobody could. There's nobody going to be sitting in his chair that can convince enough owners that they need a floor. It's not the cap, it's the floor. That's a fine line to walk. They botched the minor league thing because bean counters are in charge. You got to stop with bean counters. Bean counters kill more industries than anybody, because they just sit there and go bump, 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 have no feel, zero feel. I'm sick and tired of people who have no feel for their jobs. None. Oh, no, I've got numbers. No, take your numbers, stick them. Okay? And you have to know how to use the numbers. You have to have a feel for the job. You have to have a feel for the sport. You have to have a feel for what's going on out there. You just can't sit there all the time and tell everybody, I've got numbers. I don't want to hear about your numbers. Okay? What does your gut tell you? Hey, you can use numbers to back that up. That's fine. I'm okay with that if you want to back it up with numbers. Okay. But you've got to have a sense, an instinct. That's what Manfred doesn't have. He doesn't have an instinct for the job. He doesn't have an instinct for the game. Every time I call it a sport, you tell me it's a business. Every time I call it a business, you call it a sport. You can't have that. And that's the problem with it. See, I found positives. I don't operate in a world of hate.
That's all correct.
I don't operate in a world of hate. Yeah. I want my kids to grow up and be positive about life.
Right?
I don't want to suddenly teach my kid to say all rise, and then all of a sudden he's a Colorado Rocky. Today's show brought to you by Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors Key, Routes 11 and 15, Hummel's Wharf, on News Radio 1070 WKOK.
Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
I always feel like the news break is important. Gives Matt a chance to calm down.
As I've said before, this show is always cathartic for me. In most cases.
Today's show brought to you by our good friends at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15, Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. Ford, Kia, Hyundai, the best in new inventory, all with great warranties. Pre-owned inventory with the Sunbury Motors Guarantee, which is so critical to the buying experience. Great service department. Routine like oil changes, inspections, diagnostics. They handle it all at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15. Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. All right. Great to have you with us on the show today. Giancarlo Stanton hit his usual pre-fourth inning home run today.
You, sir, are my hero!
You never really thought about that until I started bringing it up, did you?
No, not really.
And what pattern have you noticed since I brought it up?
Verbatim of what you just said.
5-3 Yankees, top of the eighth. Brewers lead the Rays 4-3, bottom of the eighth. Top of the seventh, Nationals lead the Pirates 6-5. Mets and Astros now scoreless in the ninth. Royals lead the Rangers 2-1 to the bottom of the sixth. And the long national nightmare known as Kyrie Irving is now over. He has signed a $36 million deal to stay with the, or he's exercised the option of $36 million to stay with the Nets. Imagine what the Nets are thinking. Great. Really? Okay. The NBA salary cap, by the way, in the sport that has a cap, is going to see an $11.6 million increase to $123.6. The Sixers are going to spend theirs on a 90-year-old guy. Okay. Tucker's 90, isn't he?
You're about 63 years off.
No, 53 years off.
Yeah, that, right.
Every once in a while, it shows up that you went to Clarion.
Get the lingerie on the deck. Call the janitor.
Oh, boy. National Collegiate Basketball Hall of Fame, Roy Williams, Jim Calhoun, John Beilein, Lon Kruger will all be going, along with Jerry Krause and players Richard Hamilton of UConn, Larry Miller of North Carolina, Frank Selvey of Furman, and Jimmy Walker of Providence. That's the College Hall of Fame. All right. And it looks like the Knicks are going to try and get Jalen Brunson from the Mavericks. Freddie Freeman fired his representatives who led in negotiations that sent him to the Dodgers. This is the problem I have with this. You have so many people now around you on your team. Do you lose contact of your own reality at that point? Last I checked, who has the final say on yes or no? It's got to be Freddie Freeman. Freeman was offered a 5-year, $135 million deal to stay with the Braves. It's pretty good. 5 years, $135 million? Wow. Was it, what, $28 million a year? Somewhere in that range? And deadline came and went. The Braves bumped their offer to $140 million. And now you're talking about 5 years, $140 million. Wow. Deadline came and went. The Braves then went out and got Matt Olson for 8 years, $168 million. Freeman then signed a deal with the Dodgers, 6 years, $162 million, although the deal contains $57 million in deferred salary. In the end, the Braves' offer is actually more. Why? Heavy deferrals and the Georgia state tax laws versus California, which strangles you on taxes. Freeman's going to get less money because he plays in California. So Freeman now fires his agents. You're the one who said yes or no on it. You could have had 5 years, $140 million to stay in Atlanta. You're telling me that's a hometown discount? Really?
Not only that, too, you just finally won a World Series with the Braves.
Yeah. I know.
I mean, that's why I found it puzzling at the time, is they're still a good team.
I know.
Or I should say, they're still a decent team. They're kind of in contention still with the Mets a little bit. They're playing better.
Look, at 5 years, $140 million, which is like the last offer, you're not exactly taking a vow of poverty. That's how I look at it. You're not exactly taking a vow of poverty. So he fired his agents. Hey, you're the one that in the end had the yes or no, right? You said no? they moved on. And so, you know, look, and part of this is obviously the emotion of going back to Atlanta. I think that probably has a lot to do with it. But there it is. So I tell Matt, don't get so emotional about things. Look what happens.
No, but it's odd, though. Like, I've never really seen this before where you see, I mean, it's common that you've seen guys that were big parts of championship teams, they leave to get bigger contracts in a bigger market or a different team the following season. We've seen that before, but he comes home, and then, like, all this blows up. So it really does kind of seem the fact, like, man, like, I forgot how much I love this place and how much I was beloved in this place, how much I meant to the team winning a championship last year. But again, like you said, you're the one that left, dude.
Well, you're the one in the end had the final say of yes or no as to whether to accept the contract or not.
I mean, it's not like they booed you. They welcomed him back.
Well, I know.
He got standing ovations every time he went up to bat, as he should have.
That adds to the emotion of it.
Yeah. I think you're right. I think it all caught up to him, and he forgot how much he had it good there in Atlanta. It's very strange.
Yeah. No, it is very strange. Very, very strange. So, that is, again, you have so many people now that are in your, quote, team. I'm telling you, these people lose contact sometimes with what's going on because of they're too, insulated. How about that? They're too insulated. And they're not in tune with everything that's going on. I mean, that's how, I mean, that's, again, that's just my opinion, but you always hear all the time about you know, my team, my team, my team. And I think people lose contact with who their team is, you know, because they're so insulated from everything. Like, take Koepka. Now, Koepka's talking about the live thing and the whole thing. Well, I got people that handle that. Now, there's certain points in life where you got to handle it. So I see the Freeman thing. I see the Koepka thing. And, well, I don't handle that part. Well, actually, you do. You are the product. So actually, you do have to handle it. That's why, in the end, you're responsible for it. All right. We'll take a break. Hey, Matt's surrounded by a team.
Kind of, sort of.
Back with more in a moment as we continue here on News Radio 1070 WKOK.
When car repairs get difficult.
Well, I just don't know.
Me neither.
We get good. Sunbury Motors. More than quality new and used cars, Sunbury Motors specializes in complicated auto repair diagnosis. They can handle intricate repairs and even complete auto body with service open Monday through Friday, 7 till 4. And Sunbury Motors has made simple repairs easy. Maintaining your vehicle is necessary. Finding the time to do it is difficult. Welcome to Sunbury Motors Quick Lane. Open 7 till 4, Monday through Friday. Just walk in or call ahead. Relax in their remodeled waiting room with Wi-Fi, beverages, and snacks. Will Sunbury Motors factory trained techs take care of your oil change, tire alignments, brakes, and inspections. Quick Lane, 6:30 to 6, Monday through Friday. Saturday, 6:30 till 2. Sunbury Motors, Ford and Hyundai, North 4th Street, Sunbury. And Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. We take the out of auto repair.
All right, great to have you with us on the show today. Sponsored by our good friends at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors, Kia, routes 11 and 15, Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. Yeah. Great to have you with us on the show today. The Yankee game over with? I mean, anybody at that game? Or?
It's probably not the best crowd of the year, considering it's, well, I guess it's probably a decent crowd. I don't know. I haven't seen any yet. 5-3, top of the ninth.
Whew. Long national nightmare of Oakland A's baseball is almost over. John Sauber in the next half hour. We're going to talk Penn State football. Lift for Life is tomorrow. And we'll also talk some Penn State basketball and the reseat that is taking place in the Jordan Center. It's something I've wanted to see for 20 years. And again, for anybody who is having their seat moved, your arguments are absolutely valid and worthy of listening to. There is no question. But this is something that I've wanted to see for a while, because long term, for the perception of the program and the perception of excitement in the building, TV cameras want to shoot toward the benches. And if you put the students behind the benches, who are standing and jumping up and down to go with the shots of the benches, it brings more excitement through the TV. And I think that it is something that, in terms of the perception you want to put forward, it's something that has needed to be done. That's why for 20 years I've wanted to see it done. To get that kind of feel on TV. You have to have that kind of feel on TV for it. You just have to. And that's just the way it is today. And again, anybody who is upset with, I can't believe it, I've had my see forever, I'm absolutely sympathetic to that. But if you're asking me what is best, in my opinion, for the long term of the program, in terms of the perception long term, that can get a recruit watching a game feeling like there's excitement coming through the TV set, I think this is the move you have to make. That's why I've been for it for such a long time. I wish they'd done it a long time ago. That way they could have eliminated 20 years ago the thought process behind moving people. But to me, it's something that needed to be done. And I'll talk to John Sauber about that in the next half hour. Today's show brought to you by Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15, Elmels Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com on News Radio 1070 WKOK.